Hello everyone, the topic is Introduction to CIST. Now this is a very important topic from your third years and even the final years. Whenever you get a question, so this is the most commonly thing that is asked, that is the definition and the classification, and then they are asking any particular CIST in that. So the definition, it says a CIST, it is a pathological cavity. So you have to remember this name, it is a pathological cavity which is having fluid, semi-fluid or the gaseous content, and which is not created by the accumulation of pus. So when it is created, when a cavity, it is filled with pus, so that means it is an abscess and not a cyst. So you have to remember, if a cyst is there, so in that there is no accumulation of pus, and there would be like the cavity, it would be having fluid, semi-fluid or the gaseous content. And most of the cysts, they are lined by epithelium, but not all of them. And this definition, it was given by Karmer in 1974. So the cysts which are lined by epithelium, so they are known as true cyst, and the ones which are not lined by epithelium, so they are known as pseudocyst. So this becomes the types of the cysts, that are your true cyst and pseudocyst. So now you can see over here, so this is the cyst, so this is a cavity over here, this is the cavity, and this is lined by the epithelium, whereas in a pseudocyst you don't have this epithelium lining. So this is known as a false cyst. So the false is, the examples for it is the aneurysmal bone cyst, and for true cyst there are like many of true cysts, but pseudocysts, like there are around 5 to 6 pseudocysts only, and like all of them rest, they are true cysts. That means they are lined by the epithelium. That means when you are seeing it under the microscope, you will find that epithelium lining onto it. So this is the true cyst. So what are the now parts of a cyst? So parts of the cyst are, it is the epithelial lining, the lumen and the connective tissue wall. So this is the epithelium lining. So epithelium lining, as you know, they have various layers, and over here this is the lumen. So this is a cavity. Now over here, now you can see this is a cavity, and it is filled with the fluid or semi-fluid or the gaseous content, and after that you will find this epithelium lining, and after that you will find the connective tissue. So in connective tissue you will have all the different types of cells, that are your blood vessels, fibroblast and different type of cells. So this is how it looks under the microscope, that you'll see a connective tissue wall, then the epithelium and a lumen for a cyst. Now moving on towards the classification. So like there are various classification which are given for cyst, but the most commonly used one and the one that you should know was given by Shears. So this is a Shears classification. So he classified the cyst into basically three types, that are your cyst of the jaw, then the cysts which are associated with the maxillary atrium, and the cyst of the soft tissue of the mouth, face and neck. So these are like the three subdivision for your classification. Now we are going to focus more onto this cyst of the jaw, and we are just going to see the names for them. Like for the cyst associated with the maxillary atrium and the cyst of the soft tissues of your mouth, face and neck. Now your cyst of the jaw, it is like further divided into two types, that is the epithelial and the non-epithelium. So epithelial is the one which is known as a true cyst, and non-epithelium, they are the one which are the pseudocyst. So now the epithelial, it is again divided into two, odontogenic and non-odontogenic. Now odontogenic, odonto is nothing but the teeth. So it would be something that is associated with the teeth, and non-odontogenic is, it is not associated with the teeth, but they are the cyst of your jaw. So odontogenic, it is again divided into two types, that is your developmental and inflammatory. So inflammatory ones, they are the ones which is caused due to the inflammation. Now inflammation, it can be your caries. So because of caries, the, so this is the tooth. So over here, now these are the caries. So caries, it enters the pulp, and through the pulp and through the apical foramen, it goes into the periapical area, and then there is a formation of a periapical cyst. So basically this is an inflammatory type. Because of some inflammation, there is a formation of a cyst. Now other than inflammation, whatever the causes are, it comes into the developmental origin. So starting off with the first one, that is your epithelial and non-epithelial one. Now as epithelial, they are divided. So first we are going to see the examples for your non-epithelial. Now for, like, you need to remember all the names which comes into this subheadings. So in the non-epithelium, the point that you can remember the cysts are, like in cyst, you will get this name as a bone cyst. So there will be like different type of it. There is solitary bone cyst, or there can be aneurysmal bone cyst, traumatic bone cyst, simple bone cyst or hemorrhagic bone cyst. The non-epithelial ones, they will have this bone cyst into them. So So you will have the bone, word bone into that cyst. So that means it is a non-epithelial one. So these are the five examples for your non-epithelial one. That means it is a pseudocyst without the epithelial lining. Now as the epithelial, they are again divided into odontogenic and non-odontogenic. So first we are going to see the examples for non-odontogenic. As a non-odontogenic, they are not divided. So it becomes easier to first learn the examples for the ones which are not divided again. So the examples for non-odontogenic, it comes as a mid-palatine raphe cyst of impens. The next is the nasopalatine duct cyst. Next is nasolabial duct cyst. Then median palatal cyst. And the last one is the globulomaxillary cyst. Now over here now you can see the names of this cyst, they don't have anything which is related. So over here now you can see there is nasolabial, then there is nasopalatine, mid-palatine. So because of that, they become a non-odontogenic cyst as they do not have any like relation with the teeth. So these are your non-odontogenic cyst. Now over your odontogenic cyst, now again they're divided into developmental and inflammatory. So first we are going to see the examples for your developmental. So developmental, so there are like various and many examples for your developmental. So first example is the gingival cyst of infants. Then the gingival cyst of adults. After that, the next example is OKC, that is your odontogenic keratocyst. The next example is dentigerous cyst. Then the next example is eruption cyst. The next example is developmental lateral periodontal cyst. Then there can be glandular odontogenic cyst, calcifying odontogenic cyst. So like there are various and many examples in your developmental. In that, you just need to remember like 5 to 6. If you get a question and if you need to write it in your exams, then you need to write like these are the simpler ones. So these are the gingival cyst of infant, gingival cyst of adults, odontogenic keratocyst, because this is a commonly one. So we are going to see about it also. Then the next is a dentigerous cyst, which is associated with the impacted teeth. Then the eruption cyst. Then there is another which is a developmental lateral periodontal cyst. So these are the examples that you can write in the developmental origin. Now what are the inflammatory cysts? So now inflammatory, now we have seen because of caries you get this cyst, that is periapical cyst. So this periapical cyst is nothing but a radicular cyst. So the most commonly seen one is the radicular cyst because of the caries, as if the caries it is untreated. So because of that it goes into the pulp, and through this pulp it goes into the periapical area through this apical foramen, and this leads to the formation of a cyst, and which is known as a radicular cyst. And there can be another inflammatory, that is a residual cyst. Now what exactly all this are, I'm going to explain. The next can be inflammatory collateral cyst. And one more example for your inflammatory origin is paradental cyst and juvenile paradental cyst. So these are the four examples for your inflammatory cyst. So now this was all about the cyst of the jaws. Now the examples for the cyst which are associated with the maxillary interim is the benign mucosal cyst and a post-operative maxillary cyst. So these two are the examples for the maxillary atrium. So the last is the cyst of the soft tissues of the mouth, face and neck. Now the examples for this are dermoid and epidermoid cyst. So these all are the examples that we have already studied in our general surgeries. So first example is dermoid and epidermoid cyst. The next is a thyroglossal duct cyst. The next example, it can be anterior median lingual cyst, then cystic hygroma, nasopharyngeal cyst, thymic cyst, then the cyst of the salivary gland. That can be your mucocils. So mucocils, again, they are of two types. That is the extravasation type and the retention type. So these two, again, it comes into this cyst of the soft tissue, that is the cyst of the salivary gland. Then it can be like the other example for the salivary gland cyst is a ranula. The other cyst can be paracystic cyst, which can be hydatid cyst. So these all are like the few examples of the cyst of the soft tissues of the mouth, face and neck. In this diagram, I have drawn all the important cysts And like, what are the incidents of that particular cyst? So the most commonly found cyst is a periapical cyst, that is your radicular cyst, and the percentage is 52.30%. So this is the most commonly found cyst, and this is your radicular cyst, that is the cyst which is formed because of the inflammation. The next cyst which is commonly found is a dentigerous cyst, that is the 18.10%. So dentigerous cyst, now over here you can see this is an impacted tooth. So the cyst which covers the impacted tooth is known as a dentigerous cyst. The next commonly found one is the OKC, that is your odontogenic keratocyst. The percentage is 11.60%. OKC, it can be multilocular or unilocular, and this is like the most dangerous type of cyst. Now the next one is the residual cyst, and it is 8%. So residual cyst, now you can see there is no tooth which is present, and this cyst, it is formed if the tooth is extracted, or it would be like if there is a cyst which is present around the tooth, and in that case you are not removing the cyst properly and you are extracting the tooth, so that becomes your residual cyst. The next are the lateral periodontal cyst. So over here now you can see it is present lateral to your teeth. So this is a lateral periodontal cyst. The next is a eruption cyst. Now as the name says, eruption cyst. So when the teeth is erupting, so at that time this is the eruption. So the next one is the gingival cyst, the cyst which you will find in the gingiva. So this is found in the gingiva, so hence it is known as gingival cyst. The gingival cyst is again of two types. It is gingival cyst of infants and gingival cyst of adults. Now about all this cyst, I'm going to cover each one of them like in depth. This was all about the introduction to the cyst. So the most important thing is the definition and the classification from this introduction of the cyst. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you so much.